In this video, I'm going to tell you one of the most important steps to building wealth. Stick around and learn the one thing that could be sabotaging your efforts to get ahead and save a lot of money. Everybody wants to grow wealth, and everybody wants to know that in the future they're going to have a comfortable reserve of money to see them through the good times and the bad, to allow them to enjoy life, to go on vacations, to enjoy hobbies and pastimes, just to do whatever they want. But part of the problem is that during someone's working years, when they're bringing in regular income, they often forget about saving or looking to the future, and instead they think about what they want right now. You know, what will give them that dopamine rush right now? What will satisfy them right now? Whether it's a new car or a bigger TV set, whether it's a trip every day to the coffee shop or eating out every day, these are the things that people think about, and this is where their money goes. And if you sit down at the end of every month and you add up how much money you spent on all these niceties or all these luxuries, you'll learn that you're spending a lot of money, and you may be surprised at how much you really are spending. The truth is, you don't need these things. Many of these things will not do you any good in the future. That $8 cup of coffee will be enjoyable while you're drinking it, but it won't help you 10 years from now when you may need some financial resources for an emergency, or you may need some extra savings to take a trip, go on a special vacation that you've been dreaming about for years. It's much better to reserve some of those monies and be able to enjoy life later on. Now, the truth is that it takes a lot of convincing, and it takes a change of thinking to make good decisions about your money. People who are wealthy didn't get that way just by squandering money all the time. Most of them worked and saved and scrimped and made good money decisions and practiced good money management to get there. Now, in the first of this series on financial planning and personal finance and accumulating wealth, my message to you is that you need to stop wasting money. That may sound like a very simple principle, but in reality, everyone, and I'm talking to you, the person watching this video, everyone wastes money in some way. And especially if you have a lot of discretionary income, if you're doing really well, you're making a good income, then you're most likely wasting money on things that you don't need. If you're just living paycheck to paycheck, or you'd like to make a lot more, you may not be wasting as much money, but chances are you're still doing something to waste money. So here is the first rule I would suggest to help you accumulate wealth and that is stop spending money on things that aren't absolutely necessary. Now, you hear a lot of financial planners and a lot of people that make videos on personal finance refer to not spending money on that cup of coffee every day. And as much as I don't want to use that example, there is a lot of truth to that. The fact of the matter is you can spend $4 or $5 or even $8 on a large frappe or something. And you may be one of those people that does that every day. If you sit down at the end of the week and add up what you spend on coffee, it comes out to quite a lot. You could be spending $30 or $40 or more a week, just on coffee or coffee drinks. But that's only one example. Going out to eat is another example. Going out to eat is very expensive compared with eating at home. You really don't need to go out to eat more than once every couple weeks. And I know you may be looking at me right now saying, look, that's one of my only enjoyable experiences or gifts to myself, and I'm not going to miss eating out. But eating out is expensive, and it hasn't gotten any cheaper in the last 10 years. What you could go to the grocery store and buy for one meal out at a restaurant, at a good restaurant, could feed a couple people for a week. So my suggestion would be to stop eating out, or if you eat out every day or every other day, stop doing that and eat out maybe once every couple weeks. You'll appreciate it that much more. And I would also urge you to stop buying expensive coffee drinks if you do that. Other examples are trying to dress to impress by paying full retail for expensive clothing. Many people are either buying or leasing very expensive cars that are above their means, and that is just pure waste. Especially if you're leasing a car, you're not accumulating any ownership equity in the car when you are leasing it. And when you're buying a new car and you drive it off the lot, right away you're losing 20% of the value that day that you drive it off the lot. How much smarter would it be to buy a year-old car that is covered under warranty, that doesn't have many miles on it, but is considerably cheaper? These are the kind of things that you can do to save money. Now, the important thing is, in partnership with saving money on these things, is actually doing something with that money to accumulate it and start growing your wealth. So by stopping the trend of wasting money, that's only half the equation. The other half, of course, is to take that money and put it into some type of savings vehicle or investment vehicle and actually allow it to grow. Now, there are many choices for that, and we'll get into some of those in more detail in future videos. But one of the simpler routes would be just to put it into a bank savings account. The drawback, of course, is that you are probably earning less than 1% interest, but at least you're accumulating money. And if you get in the habit of putting money aside every week, then at least the money is growing and it's not going out the window to the local coffee shop or your favorite restaurant. So that would be my first advice, stop wasting money. And you know, there are really so many examples of how people waste money and how you may be wasting money. Besides clothes and cars, a lot of people buy homes above their means, often to either keep up with the Joneses, as the old expression goes, or to impress. But if you're just getting by paycheck to paycheck and you feel like you have to buy a 2,800 or 3,000 square foot home, maybe you're living above your means. If you're renting a luxury apartment, maybe you need to bring it down a notch and live within your means, and any amount of money you save, you need to make sure to put aside and save. Other examples would be, for instance, cable television. If you're paying over $100 a month for a cable TV bill, you're wasting money. That's not really necessary. You have to think about whether or not you're actually making use of all those channels every month, and is it really worth it? Some people get by and cut the cable, as the expression goes, and just use network TV, or they use an internal antenna, and they get a lot of the digital channels locally, and that often fills the bill. But at the very least, if you want to keep cable, you can revert to a more basic plan that saves you money as well. This again, I believe, is an area of just simply a waste, where it's an excess, and in many cases it's like throwing money out your car window as you drive down the highway. There's just really no need for it. So step one in building wealth would be not so much an emphasis on where you save money, but an emphasis on stopping some of your current behaviors that are wasting and squandering money. And in order to build wealth, you can't waste money regardless of what your income is. Let's think about cutting out the waste, accumulating more of that money, systematically saving that money every week, whether you have the money withdrawn from your paycheck directly going into a bank account, a mutual fund account, or brokerage account, or you save the money on your own and deposit it into a bank account. Maybe you set up a separate account specifically for long-term savings, and you set that up with the intention of not touching it. The bottom line is that over a number of years, you will have accumulated quite a lot of money, and you'll be surprised at how much you do. I started my financial services career convincing people to save money all the way back in 1980, and some of the people I've spoken to in more recent years accumulated so much money by systematically saving money that it helped them live very comfortable lives in retirement, and also it allowed them to have money that came out of these savings accounts to directly pay off mortgages and allow them to travel and do other enjoyable things without any worries about being short. So it's real, it works, and it is what you really need to take seriously and start today or tomorrow. Don't put it off. Stay tuned for every video, because we will get into things like reducing debt, different savings vehicles that you can use to accumulate wealth, different forms of investment, and other things that will both help you save money, accumulate money, and not waste money. Thanks for watching this video. And please, like it if it helped you with information on your road to growing wealth. And please subscribe so you never miss a single video in the series. Each one will cover another facet of growing your wealth.